So isolations are going to be a really important part of dance, especially in jazz and hip-hop. So what it means to isolate is you mean you move only one part of your body. I'm a little out of breath because I just did the warm-up. I hope you did too, because you should always start whatever exercise you're doing with a nice solid warm-up, okay? We're going to start isolations in second position parallel. So our feet are both facing front. If it's slightly turned up, that's okay too. But a nice solid posture, chest is up, ribs are in, abs are activated, shoulders are down. From here, you can either have your hands on your hips or just straight down. We're gonna start with the head. Going down, up, down, up. Now you wanna move that head as much as you can. Big range of motion, but you don't wanna move anything else. After that, we go side to side. Right, left. Again, big range of motion, but not moving anything else. After that, tilt, right and left. Again, try not to let your shoulders move with this in any way. Try and keep your shoulders nice and down. Then we roll around, and we roll the other way. And then we move on to our shoulders. Shoulders go straight up, straight down. Then we move to a roll back. Again, try as much as you can not to move the rest of your body. So try not to let your rib cage get into this. Try to make it only your shoulders that are moving as much as you can. Then we do that same thing going forward. After that, we take our arms out and you're going to rotate your arm in the socket. So don't think about going forward. Think about rotating the arm. So if you look at it from the side, palm facing up, palm facing back. Rotating that arm in the socket. And you're alternating from one side to the other. Okay? After that, we have ribs. So now, you can move your ribs. Try as much as you can not to move your shoulders or your hips. So pressing the ribs forward and pressing the ribs back, contracting in. Pressing the ribs forward and back from the side. You should really be able to see forward and then back. Trying to get, you're gonna move a little bit, but try as much as you can to isolate into your ribs. Yeah, really activating the abs in that contraction. We go side to side as well, moving to the side, right and left. And then we go around in a circle, and then we go around the other way. From here we have hips, right and left. You can bend the knees slightly so you can have a bigger range of motion. I wanna see that hip, don't be shy. No hips here, yes, big hips. You should feel that stretch on the side of your hips. We roll to the right a couple of times. Then we roll to the left a couple of times. Then we do a figure eight. So we switch off right and left. Right and left. Trying to draw like an eight shape with your hips. From there, we take a nice big plie. Reach up. Collapse down with your head being the last thing to come down. Then you come back up again. As you come up, it's one vertebrae at a time, so your head comes up last. We do that from the side so you can see the ribs and the spine. Reaching up, looking up to the sky, keep looking until you can't. From here, you can see one vertebrae stacking on top of the other until the head comes up last. So we reach up and we do it again. After that, we're going to do feet. So I'm going to take off my shoes so you can see it better. So what happens is we lift one foot off the ground and you have it flexed. We're going to go demi point, point, demi point, flex. So from the side, so you can see the foot a little bit better, from flex. Your demi point is when the ball of your foot is pressing down, but your toes are still pressing up. It's the same position if you're on releve, if you're on your tippy toes, right? So demi point, then point all the way with your toes, then back to demi point, and flex. Flexing is an active motion, it's not just relaxing there. Pull that toe back as far as possible. We do that a few times, then we switch sides. So that's it for isolations. We'll do it with music, and I'll face the back so that you can follow along with me if you'd like. Okay.
like a bubble of that beat in my heart.